Today, I would like to talk about how customs, that is kind of like a very traditional organization, maybe one of the oldest organizations in the world, try to adapt and use the big data. And then we would like to talk about how the postal service can help us in terms of data and why that is beneficial of the postal service too. The role of customs is changing so much. So traditionally it is now still, but about the revenue collection and the protection of economic interest in the society. But now, after September 11th, the role on the security becomes so high, and also we have a strong need for the facilitating trade. So this kind of like roles, to meet these roles, we try to use the risk management as the really important techniques. And to do the risk management, we really need the information and data. So when I was listening to the keynote presentation, I noticed that risk management is some kind of like a prediction. Using the prediction and use the like a data to like a signal data to see what is the good to find out the trend which is related to the like, kind of like organized crime, that kind of stuff. And the risk management, we can do that manually, but it's really time consuming. So we really need that data. So this is the instrument. We have so many instruments, but I noticed that most of the instruments related to how to use the data. So we have so many things around here. And last year, we decided to have the theme, last year we decided to have the theme as the digital customs. And this year, our theme for the WCO is that data analysis for the effective border management, that is include the how to use the big data. What is big data for the customs? As the definition of the big data is so different. And we are, as I said, the customs is a very traditional organization. So we are not like the Amazon or Google, but still big data tells a lot. So there are two classifications of the data according to our research. The one is kind of like a regular submission of data. I can say that this is kind of like a formatted type of data. Like we can analyze it by the Excel or the Access, that kind of thing. And traditionally we have the import or export goods declaration. And now we are moving into the advanced electric information, which I'm going to tell later, but that is about the getting information a little bit earlier stage than the arrival. And then we are moving into the next stage of the partnership with the private sectors. And that is more, what can I say, it's not formatted data, but it's a kind of like a text, like a long text data, not formatted, but they can tell us a lot. And the type of data in this category is kind of like a commercial transaction data. And the like a logistics data, for example, like a GPS can tell us so many things about the movement of the goods. And also there are huge data in the social media, like a Facebook and other things. So first, what we have to do is to analysis of the big data of the kind of like a traditional type of the data, like a formatted data. So we go into that area, and many customs are already doing many job on there. Like and this kind of analysis can tell us historical shipment trends or deviations or specific trend and pattern of the trade environment. But the next category is data, like a big data gain from the partnership helps us more. For example, to reduce the kind of like area which we are still doing like manual handling, and can ensure the accuracy of data itself. And we can get the data at the earlier stage. That is really important for us. and we can get a, we can conduct a risk targeting from the various perspective. So where we want to go is that we need a customs intelligence platform. We already have it, but we have to improve it. We really want to improve that one. And network with the business operator system in a coordinated fashion is really important for us. This is the current, I would like to talk a little bit on the current situation. So the timing of receiving data, or maybe the visibility of the data of the cargo to the customs. So I compare three areas, means of transport. In case of sea cargo, nowadays, several customs can receive the information 24 hours before the loading at the port of the exportation. In case of air cargo, 4 hours before the arrival or even earlier. But in case of the international mail, as this picture shows, so we gather information after the arrival when the customs official get the cargo itself and see, take a look on it and see the CM 22 or 23. That is the time when the customs get the information on the international mail. We have to think of the huge impact of the e-commerce in the area of the customs procedure. So what we have to do because of this huge increase of e-commerce, so we need to control over the large volume of small parcels. But not only that, we have to control over the increased individual importers. And we need to, so that we need to receive the electric reporting, especially in the international mail, that is urgently, and so that we can minimize the impact of the legitimate trade. And we have to decrease the opportunities for the organized crime. So here I would like to touch upon on the what we are doing on the advanced electric information. So this is the formatted data. So maybe in the first category of the big data, but still this is really useful for us. So in the safe framework of standard to secure and facilitate trade, it mentioned about advanced electric information. And in 2015, SAFE was revised to include for the pre-loading data submission for the air cargo. That is a huge, huge development. And also we have the immediate release guideline, and that is to how to clear the cargo immediately with the data. And also we have the WSO data model, and that provides kind of like standard international harmonized data and data format. So the UPU and the WCO has developed common data format and styles data set based on this WCO data model. And also Article 8.1 of the UPU Convention mentioned about the provision of the advanced electric information too. The benefit of AER is not only for customs, I would like to mention about that. So for us, maybe we can proceed customs procedure quickly, and we can focus its resource on the high risk area. But also for traders and for the postal service, you can reduce the customs clearance time and storage cost, and also avoid the unnecessary inspection for that. And also, that is an important point, but to keep the security of the trade is also a very important point for that. So what we think is that the next step is with the cooperation with the postal service, AER reporting of the international mail, and the next step is also big data from the private sector. So while for some, I think it's in the UK or Canada or maybe in Japan, there's a pilot project exchange of the AER data between the postal service and submitted to the customs organization too. And also about the big data from the private sector, we have the e-commerce working group discussing about how we can utilize commercial data so that we can proceed customs procedure area in the earlier stage. But it's not so easy to utilize the big data. So this is the challenges we already figure out. The first one is the integrity of the data, because we really have to get the accuracy of the data. So that is the first point. And we have to integrate the data, get from the various kind. Sometimes the format is so different. We have to connect two kinds of data together so that we can use as a big data. And the next thing is, maybe we already talked about that, but it's about the human capacity. So we definitely need more and more IT professionals. And also, we talk about the mindset, but that happened to the customs organization too. Because the anyway, if we use the big data and we analyze that, so the, in the management level have to use that result to the decision and the operation. So we really need that kind of thing. And the other thing is that the accessibility of the data is still there. And the capability, so that is to store and manage the large volume of the data set. And the last thing is to centralization of the data. I think this is really important point, because still now we are in the organization, there are various kind of data in many places. So first, it's really useful to collect all the data in your organization first and set up some kind of like center function to utilize the data. So that is the things that it's a huge challenge, but it's really useful.